Hello everyone, welcome to Beaver's Hobby Channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to convert Mini Z front wheel drive to all wheel drive. You might be wondering why anyone would convert the front wheel drive to all wheel drive. Well, if you look at the chassis type, it is MA03, which is the name for all wheel drive series. So actually, this front wheel drive chassis is the new all wheel drive chassis without the rear drive mechanism. As of now, Kyosho only sells the new all-wheel drive chassis as MA030 EVO. And if you look at the diagram, you'll see that they are identical, except for the center shaft and rear diff. Now that we know what's missing, here are the parts we need. First, the center shaft set from EVO. You can only use all-wheel drive configuration with 94 and 98mm wheelbases. Next, a differential. I'll use ball differential, so I can adjust the tension and lock it when I want to drift. Two ball bearings, size 6x10x3mm for differential. And finally, two swing shafts. Or just buy a set of four and upgrade them all together. And since I already have everything except the center shaft, it is also cheaper than buying an EVO. I'll also take this opportunity to convert the front chassis to wide and upgrade the rear with 1.5 degree camber knuckles. I'll also need the long swing shafts for the front Y conversion as well. Now that we have all the parts ready, let's begin. I'll remove the front knuckles first to install the long shafts. Pull the clips up and pull the pins out at the front. Next, remove the rear assembly by removing these four screws. I'm building the rear camber knuckles now, so I have all the upgrades ready to go on the car. Onto the main chassis, first remove the motor mount. Undo the screw and unclip the mount. Then remove the motor wires. Now lift the front up, and the motor will come off like this. Next, remove the board. Be very careful because there are a lot of wires here and you don't want to break any of them. Gently remove the servo motor's back cover off to reveal a screw under it. Then undo that screw. Now remove the battery terminals to get to the tunnel. Remove it as well. Then pull the board out along with the servo motor. Next, remove the front diff cover. And then remove the center cover. And here is the center shaft. This is the short shaft for front wheel drive. We will replace this with the long shaft for all wheel drive. There are two of the small bearings here. Put one on the shaft. Make sure the switch is in there. Now put the shaft in. The bearing goes into the slot at the back. And the shaft goes through the tunnel at the front. Then put another bearing in at the front. And put the spur gear in. Turn the shaft until you can feel the slot in the spur gear, then push it in. Now put everything back together. Be very careful not to break any wire, especially the servo motor's wires, which are very difficult to put them back on. All of this takes really long, and if you want to see the whole process, I have another long uncut video for you to see how difficult and fiddly it is to take it apart and put it back together. As for the Y chassis conversion, take the narrow bottom plate out, and put the bolts into the Y bottom plate. Replace the tie rod, and put the bottom plate on. Put the diff in, then replace the top plate. And it is done. Now I have the Y chassis at the front, and I can put the motor back on the car. Moving on to the back. Remove the top cover. And only install the bottom on the chassis. Put the diff in. If you use other diff that's not the standard gear diff, make sure to shim it properly so you have good gear mesh and it won't chew up your gears. Close the rear diff housing. And it is done. Here we have MA-030 all-wheel drive. Now let's do the speed test. With front wheel drive, it clocked at 21 km an hour. With all wheel drive, it is reduced to 20 km an hour. So top speed is lower, but it'll be much better in the corners. And of course, now that it is all wheel drive, it can drift. In conclusion, until Kyosho decide to sell this new all wheel drive chassis as ready set, if you already have most of the parts, it is cheaper to buy the front wheel drive and convert it to all wheel drive than buying an MA-030 EVO. Also, the board is shorter, which will come in handy if you want to upgrade the rear to double wishbone suspension. And that's it for this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this and press the bell icon to get notification whenever I upload a new video. You can follow me on Facebook to see what I'm doing between videos along with some quick updates. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.